In this video, we're going to see how to customize and personalize your SketchUp workspace even with your custom watermark and template. What's going on, fellas? I'm Geo and this is Geo Creations. You can find me on Instagram as Geo Jerwin. Let's jump right into the video. Today we are going to learn to customize some of the basic elements like lines, guides, edges and faces, optimizing for different purposes and how to make your preferred style, and finally making personal branding in your workspace. As I promised in my last video where I have explained how to upgrade your SketchUp workflow, click on this I button or check out the link in the description to watch that video. Now let's see what we can do to make your workspace define you. To edit your style, make sure if the styles are enabled in your default tray. If not, go to Window, Default Tray and make sure that style is checked. And now in the default tray, look for your styles. These are the default ones, and you can also choose some of the default artistic styles like this. Now, under the Model tab, you can see all the styles you have selected so far. To get rid of them, click on the button over here and select Purge Unused. Now let's see how to make your own style. Click on this button to edit the current style. Let's start with the background. Click on this button over here to edit your background. Here you can set your custom colors for your background, sky, and the ground. Also, you can adjust the transparency of the ground to control the visibility of anything below the ground. I prefer turning both of them off. Now let's move on to edit the faces. Here you can customize the color of your front and back face. And you can choose between wireframe, unshaded, shaded, shaded with texture, or shaded with the same material. And also you can use the X-ray mode and set the transparency for it. Now let's take a quick look into editing lines. If you turned on back edges, you can see all the hidden edges as dots. Profiles will render a thick line around your model. This will cost your system's performance if worked on a larger scale. I've explained that in detail in my last video. Depth Cube is basically profiles, but it changes its thickness according to the perspective. The closer areas look thicker and the farther areas look thinner. Extensions basically extends your edges furthermore to your endpoint, thus giving us a sketchy effect. Now you can also turn on jitter to make all your edges kinda look sketchy, and the endpoints thickens all of your intersection points. The thickness of these things and the length of the extension are also customizable. And in the modeling section, you can set the rest of the options like color of your edges, guides and sections. You can also color your model according to the layers or tags. This will make your modeling far easier and effective. In the mix section, you can select a particular part of your favorite style and make it into a new style. Now you can play with these and figure out what works the best for you. To save your settings, name your style here and click on the refresh button over here. Now you can find your style in the model section, click on it and select save as. And now make a folder especially for your custom SketchUp styles and select it. To open your custom style on a new file, click on this button over here and select open or create a collection. Now select your folder and you are good to go. And now I'm gonna show my settings, which I optimized for the best performance. First, let's start with the line settings. Here I'm not gonna select anything except for edges. In the face style, I'm gonna make my front face a little bit darker than white, and I'm gonna make the back face a little bit lighter than black. And also gonna leave the face style as shaded with texture. Now let's move on to the background settings. In this, I'm gonna set my background somewhere around gray, and I'm not gonna use sky or ground. It works fine for me. Do some small color tweaks in this modeling section, which I have no impact on the performance. And now creating your own branding inside SketchUp. Before that, make sure to click that like button. It helps me a lot. Okay, let's get back to the topic. For creating a watermark like this, you first need to make your watermark in an image format. Make it as a PNG if you need the transparency. Now go to watermark settings by clicking on the button right over here. Click on the plus icon to load your custom logo or any image. Now set your scale, position and transparency. You can also make a pattern overlay like this to discourage someone to copy your design before paying for it. And let's see how to set up your custom template where you can literally set your own model to be preloaded for each project. To make something like SketchUp's human figure, there are two ways to do it. The first way is to trace your image in AutoCAD or SketchUp itself, or make an image using Photoshop, and this is a method which I followed. After bringing in the image, you can't make it as a component straight away. For some reason, SketchUp won't allow you to make a single image as a component. To make it possible, we can draw a very small line which is not noticeable. Now select the both and make it as a component. Now we need to set up this to align its view along the camera. To do that, go to component, select your component, and in the edit tab, check always face the camera. You can do this for any component.
Save this file as a template.
If you learned something new today, consider joining the community by subscribing to the channel. If you have any questions or suggestions, feel free to leave that in the comments. Signing out for now, catch you guys in the next video. See ya.